back, everybody. What a wonderful week of learning we've had. Can you remember what we were learning about yesterday? Carlo had a new and challenging number to learn about. He learned about the number that comes after five. The number six. Well done, everybody. Do you remember the party we had yesterday? We had six people that came to the party. We had six placemats. We had six plates. We had six serviettes. We had six spoons. We had six cups. We had six cupcakes. We had enough for every creature and person at that party. We had enough for everyone at that party. We had no more than six, and we had no less. Great work, and thank you for your help. Let's check Carlo's bag today and see if his communication book's in there and if there's anything else. It's very light, and actually today, Carlo, it's very empty. Lucky he's brought his communication book along. Yesterday we talked about a big number. Yesterday was day 14. So today is day, who's got it big numbers? Today is day 15. If we didn't know that automatically, we could count back a bit and lead in. Can you help me? Count from 10. 10, 11, 12, 13. Yesterday was day 14 and today is 15. Well done to all the 4 and 5 year olds out there today who guessed that. Just a short note today, and it says, dear children and Joe, thank you for all your help. This is a really good news. The park ranger thinks that Carlo will be a fabulous carer and helper at the park. Oh dear, Carlo. His first job is on the weekend, and he's going to be helping the ranger to care for the baboons. So that includes the monkeys and the gorillas and the chimpanzees. In this enclosure, this is lucky, in this enclosure there will be six baboons. Carlo does know this. Baboons love to play games. They're kind of a bit like humans. So Carlo is planning some games for them, and he's going to teach them all about the number, can you guess? The number after five, the number six through game. I'm wondering if you can practice with him today so he's well and truly prepared. Love from and thank you from Carlo's family. Right, Carlo. Let me just check what that first game might be. I wondered why he put the number track back on the table. Can you help me count the numbers? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the number after five is 6. Okay, I think I know this game, Carlo. What we're going to do is cover a number. I want you to close your eyes. Are you ready? No peeping. Right, you can open. I want you to have a close look at that number track. Can you guess which number is covered over? Have a close look. There is a few different strategies you could use. Some of you might just know by looking. Some of you might start from the beginning and count on 1, 2. You're right. It's 3. Some people might use a different strategy, and they might know that the number that comes before 4 is 3. Did you guess the number 3? Well done if you did. Okay, this is a pretty tricky game for the baboons to play. Close your eyes again. No peeping. Okay, open. I feel like this is a really easy number for people to guess because it's the very first number we learn about. It's not 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 6. It's the number that comes before 2. Did you guess this number? Well done. It's number 1. Close your eyes again. No peeping. Open. What strategy are you using? Do you know the number that comes before 6? Did you count on from the beginning? Do you know the number that comes after 4? I wonder if you guessed this number. If you guessed the number 5, you are right. Okay, let's give this one more go. Close your eyes. Are you ready? You can open. What strategy are you using this time? Are you starting from the beginning and counting all the way through? Are you using your fingers and knowing you've got 5 and adding on 1 more? I wonder if you guessed this number, the number 6. Well done, which is how many baboons Carla was going to be caring for on the weekend. Well done, everybody. You might want to have a game of that at home. The really good part about this is you can make this number track up all by yourself. All right, let's move this game to the side, Carlo. And let me find out what game Carlo wants to do next. Bag. Carlo says I need to check in his bag. There are 2 things in here. A dice and a black pen. Have you got a dice like this at your house? You'll notice it has 6 sides, but it doesn't have numbers on. It has dots to represent the numbers. We're going to start, Carlo, by rolling the dice, counting 1, 2, and then putting 2 dots next to the number 2 on our number track. Let's see if we can fill this up. Shake the dice again. Oh, this is a number we know really well now. I actually don't have to count it because I can see it, but you might want to check. That's right. It's the number 4. And on this dice, it has 2 dots at the bottom and 2 at the top. Fantastic. Another roll. And another one. We should be so good at seeing this number now. Where have you seen that before? Can you remember when we made the must have 5 zoo? And Carlo put those 5 dots on every one of the enclosures. It helped us to check that there were only 5 creatures in each enclosure. I'm going to have a go at drawing this. It's like four. It's got two down the bottom. It's got two up the top and one in the middle. Oh, I'm really hoping for a one, a three, or a six. Yes, an easy one. You should be able to see that number without counting. You're right. One dot goes right next to the number one. I've got two numbers to get. Number three or number six? Yes, the number six. Three dots on one side, three on another. I've played with dice for a very long time, so I know that six. You might have to still count and check. Let me record it. One, help me count. Two, three, four, five, six. Let's do the last one. I'm going to do a search around. The last one we have to record is the number one, two, three. And I'm going to go from one corner to another. This is going to help us with our game that Carlo's designed for us today. I might borrow one of Carlo's friends to help us, someone with long arms and jumping legs. Not the giraffe, maybe the monkey. Okay, let me check with Carlo. That sounds like a fabulous game, but I'm going to need one of your friends to help, Carlo. Someone with long arms and jumping legs. I don't think that's the giraffe, is it? Let's try the monkey. Are you ready? The monkey's ready. You might want to get yourself standing up. Here's how this game works. We're going to roll the dice. I'm going to hold the number up and show you. And then I'm going to call out, so you need to be listening, an action. And you're going to do it that many times. Are you ready? Jump. One, two, three. I wonder how high you jumped. Are you ready? Let's roll the dice. We can check it against the number if you're not sure. It's the number one. Are you ready? Can you do a somersault? Well done, everybody. We'll go again. Ah, this is Carlo's favorite number, and I'm sure you all know this one. Are you ready? Let's do 1 foot hopping. Five, let's go. One, two, three, four, five. Can you swap legs? One, two, three, four, five. Let's roll the dice one more time. Oh, an easy number. Can you see it? If you don't know what it is, check on the number track. This time, let's spin around. Are you ready? One, and back the other way. Two. Did you read that number as two? You might want to continue this game at home. All you need is the dice and yourself. Roll the dice and say the number and the action. So I'm going to say, I'm going to jump six times, but I'm not going to jump. I'm going to make the monkey jump. One, two, three, four, five, six. Let's try one more. Can you help me? I'm going to hop three times. One, two, three. The more you play with the dice, the better you will be at recognizing those numbers instantly. What's that long word we learnt last week? Can anybody remember that? That's right, it's called subitising. We see the number without having to count it. Well done. Good luck, Carlo, with your very first task as a trainee park ranger. We think you'll be just fabulous. Have a great weekend, everybody. See you next week. Bye.